Hi, I'm Josh.
I'm Ollie, and today we're going to see if we can perfectly recreate a Big Mac from scratch.
Okay, that sounds quite ambitious. This isn't Bon Appetit channel, Ollie.
No, it's
we
not.
We don't have those cooking skills.
But you know that I love stealing trade secrets.
Oh, no.
I'm the Hamburglar. The Big Mac is the quintessential fast food burger. It's a masterpiece, really, a work of art.
Sorry, it looks like you're missing a top burger. What?
I literally got this from McDonald's like half an hour
ago. No!
They made it wrong!
They
just packaged it completely empty.
Look,
in
the gherkin
top.
I'm out the side. You know what they've done? That should just be in like that. And he's just slapped it in upside down.
First up, Josh, we've got to make the special sauce.
Can we eat a little bit of it?
Once we've made our one, we can compare it.
You don't want to have an inspiration bite.
Okay, inspiration bite.
Inspiration bite.
We can do it.
We've earned it.
Ready?
Yeah.
Lady in the Tramp.
No! Just eat it.
It's called an inspiration
Lady
bite
in the burger.
For a reason.
This makes me so uncomfortable.
That was so much less enjoyable than it should have been.
Look, this is the special sauce here. So we've got to crack this. If we crack this, we've cracked the Big Mac. We need half a cup of mayonnaise.
Focus on what you're doing. There's mayonnaise going everywhere. Stop.
Two tablespoons of French dressing. Four teaspoons of sweet pickle relish.
That stuff stinks.
One tablespoon of finely minced onion. One tablespoon of white vinegar.
Wow, this is all just to make the sauce.
One teaspoon of granulated sugar. And an eighth of a teaspoon of salt.
Surely just a pinch of salt is the same thing.
Well, it depends how big your hands are.
Okay, eighth of a teaspoon.
Okay, that's not.
Okay. More whisk about the vinegar
it,
than the salt.
Whisk it. Now, we need to put that in the fridge for 24 hours.
24 hours?
You put that in the fridge for 24 hours. 24 hours has now passed.
Okay, that actually does look a better color than the one.
It
just needed 24 hours to settle.
Okay. Now, do you want to try it?
Yeah. Is that what it's supposed to taste like? It's very vinegary.
Oh, so's that.
That's also very vinegary.
Wait.
That's actually pretty much spot on. What the heck? That's basically it. What the heck?
We've cracked the trade secret.
Next up,
we're gonna cook the patties and the buns. Okay. So from one bun, it would help if you turn the knife around, and then.
Okay, so I'm cutting this into three bits.
Yes, yeah.
Okay,
all right.
And they've gotta be quite thin bits. This middle bit is tricky.
You got it. So now we just need to go downstairs, because we can't cook in here because there's a fire alarm. Right?
Oh.
Okay, yeah. You ready?
You really look like the hamburger now.
I really want to clap.
Hey, all right, meaty hands.
All right.
Let's do it.
Don't mind me, guys.
Oh my gosh.
Just conducting a science experiment.
Wait, what? Where are we going? Why is this outside? Okay.
Okay, I think you do the buns first.
Okay.
Pretty sure in McDonald's, this isn't how they wait to put the food on. And also, I'm pretty sure
they don't do it
right next to a rat trap.
Wow. Our hygiene levels. Rock bottom right now.
Is that good? Is that good?
Yeah.
All right. Lightly toasted. Okay.
Middle bit's not quite done, but oh my gosh.
Oh.
Are we actually eating this?
Yeah, man.
Okay.
We've got a Lady in the Tramp here.
Our signature. No. Careful flipping, hey. Ooh, look at that. Nice.
Those actually don't look that dissimilar from McDonald's patties.
Careful, flipping heck.
Okay, let's go back upstairs.
What sort of cooking setup is this?
All right, this is how we build it, okay? First up, bottom. What? We need to spread on some special sauce.
Okay, well, they do sometimes go a bit trigger happy with the sauce at McDonald's.
And then some onion.
How much?
A little bit more. And then lettuce.
Lettuce?
Quick.
Why quick?
There's customers waiting, Josh.
Okay. All right. How did I end up doing everything while you just hold
I'm
the patties?
I'm holding the hamburger.
Is that too big for the lettuce? Should I make the lettuce?
Yeah, a little less. American cheese.
Okay.
All right. Okay. Patty.
Right.
Middle bun. Special sauce.
Boom. More special sauce, more special sauce. Got it?
Man, I feel like I'm changing tyres in the Grand Prix.
What do you mean? We're not anywhere near quick enough. Onion.
Pickle slices or gherkin. And then beef patty on top of that.
Hey, oh, beef patty, yeah, final one.
Top bun.
Wow, this is elaborate.
There you go. According to this recipe, we should have made a Big Mac. And my hands are covered in meat juice.
Oh, I was gonna touch them, but I won't. Wow, look at this.
McDonald's executives around the world are crying into their computer screens.
Okay.
The secret's out. We just made a Big Mac.
Boom, our Big Mac versus the original Big Mac. Wow.
I'm excited about this, man.
I mean, that's pretty good.
Yeah. Okay. All right, which one do we try first? Wow. I think we've gotta try the original first.
You know what, I will, out of the kindness of my heart, let you take a bite first.
Okay, well, how about you go?
Mm.
You're an idiot.
Oh, no. Take a bite of the bloody burger.
Mmm, lovely.
Okay.
Yeah, that's a taste you recognize.
Mmm. Right, now savor that bite.
Mm-hmm.
Remember what that tastes like.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Josh, now take a bite of our burgled burger.
Jolly Mac, the burgled Mac. Wow, that's a lot of bread, isn't it? I never really realized how much the bread in a Big Mac just kind of dissolves into nothingness.
Into nothing. I mean, there's a few things that are more flavorful in that than a normal Big Mac.
Yeah.
The lettuce, for one.
Yeah.
I can actually taste lettuce.
The vegetables, yeah.
What do you make of the special sauce?
We need more of it. It needs more special sauce.
Really? Why?
Look, the special sauce in this one is leaking out.
Wow. Okay, yeah, do it. What? Oh yeah, you want it overflowing. Yeah, look at that. That's what you want. Oh wow, it doesn't look very appetizing, does it? But that's what you want. Get a bite of that and then get a specially saucy bite of that.
Mm, here comes our saucy Bigger Mac.
Oh. Yeah.
It's definitely closer.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say it's as successful as Coke was.
Okay, okay.
Coke, you shut your eyes.
Yeah, yeah.
Tasted the same.
Yeah.
This, it doesn't taste the same, but it's got that reminiscent kind of Thousand Island type flavor to it.
Mm-hmm.
I think, to be honest, it's let down by the bread.
Textures are completely different.
McDonald's bread is like iconic, right?
Bread and the beef basically just dissolves in you. Like, you don't really have to chew that. This clearly tastes higher quality, you know?
Mm-hmm.
The bread, the meat, it tastes like there's less chemicals and preservatives in there.
Mm-hmm. I know what I'd want though.
Not as good.
It's not as good.
It's just not, it's not what you want.
It's not as good.
How much did all this cost?
Well, you know, I don't like to get into specifics. let's say it wasn't cost effective.
Oh, great.
Actually, come to think of it, it's one of the more expensive burgers I've ever had.
Ever?
Well, I think it was just over 20 quid for all of the
ingredients. Wow, that was not worth it.
What trade secret should we try and steal next? There's a colonel out there.
That was rather jolly. Can't believe we actually made a Big Mac from scratch.
Oh, we tried it so you don't have to. And in the meantime,
I'll see you jolly soon.
See you later.
Bye.